Welcome, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome in Vancouver. Welcome at the FTC, the Future Technology Conference 2018. My name is Rutger Mollet, and next to me, Louis Rosenberg. And Dr. Louis Rosenberg is CEO and chief scientist of Unanimous AI, a company that amplifies human intelligence by connecting groups of people together using AI algorithms modeled on natural swarms. And in his newest study, he showed that swarm AI enabled groups of sport fans to out-predict Vegas betting markets across 200 NHL hockey games. Welcome, Louis.
Thanks for having me.
Good to have you. Hey, could you tell me what is artificial swarm intelligence and how does the amplification of intelligence in ASI work?
Yeah, so most forms of artificial intelligence are inspired by nature. And so for the last 60 years, people have been looking to nature as for ways to create artificial intelligences. Most AI research looks at neurological intelligence, which is, you know, the intelligence inside of people's brains, where you have networks of neurons that are connected together to create an intelligence. Artificial swarm intelligence looks at a different type of biological intelligence called swarm intelligence. Swarm intelligence is nature's way of building intelligence not from neurons, but from organisms, from connecting groups of organisms together to make them smarter together than alone. So swarm intelligence is the reason why birds flock, fish school, bees swarm. They are significantly smarter as a group than as individuals. Artificial swarm intelligence says, hey, if this works for birds and bees and fish, can we make it work for people? People didn't naturally evolve the ability to form swarms, but with algorithms and software and interfaces, we can connect people together. These are people who could be distributed all around the world. We can connect them together into systems modeled after natural swarms. And what we find is that they get significantly smarter when they're answering questions together as a swarm than they would as individuals.
Nice one. What's the biggest challenge in developing ASI?
So the thing that makes artificial swarm intelligence hard is that it involves both people and algorithms. Most AI research looks at replacing people with algorithms. We look at connecting people together with algorithms so they can get smarter, which means we need to connect people together in real time. And so if we're gonna do a prediction, we need to have a group of people, they could be anywhere in the world, they're gonna log into our system, and we're gonna have questions pop up on all their screens at the exact same time, and then they're gonna answer those questions together as a system, converging on answers that are optimized compared to what they would do on their own.
Yeah. Hey, what day-to-day applications of ASI do you envision in the future?
Yeah, so the thing that's really cool about artificial swarm intelligence is it allows us to take any group of people and make them smarter. And so any place where you have a group of people that you'd like to be smarter is an application. So you could imagine business teams. And in fact, we've done a lot of work with business teams where we can take a group of people together who are marketing people or sales people, and together as a swarm, they can make significantly more accurate sales forecasts or business predictions or business decisions. We even just did a research study with Stanford University Medical School where we took groups of doctors and we had them diagnose chest x-rays together as a swarm, and they got 33% more accurate in predicting, in diagnosing these chest x-rays when they were connected together as a swarm versus individuals.
Wow, nice, that's cool, that's cool. Hey, what did you research in your paper?
Yeah, so this paper looked at connecting groups of sports fans together, spread across the US and Canada, and to predict the outcome of hockey games. And so we actually had 200 hockey games. These were 10 games a week for 20 weeks, and we had them predict as individuals and then also predict as a swarm intelligence.
Yeah.
And we, when we did this, we found that this group was significantly more accurate in predicting together as a swarm. As individuals, they were just slightly better than guessing. They were 52% accurate. when they came together as a swarm intelligence, they were 65% accurate.
Wow.
And we had a betting model where we would bet simulated money on each of the games that they predicted, and they would have had 170% return on investment. They would have almost doubled their money.
Wow.
At the end of these 20 weeks by yeah. predicting as a swarm, whereas had they predicted just as individuals, they would have all lost money.
Nice one. Hey, and why did you choose the betting market as a use case for ASI?
Yeah, so we do a lot of sports predicting at Unanimous AI, partly because it's a great test bed for predicting things. Mm-hmm. We have sporting events happen every day, and then the next day we get an answer, and we know if we're right or wrong, and you can't fake it. We publish the predictions in advance. In fact, on our website, we'll publish predictions for hockey games, football games, baseball games, basketball games, and then we track these across the season, and what we see is that when we connect groups of sports fans together as a swarm intelligence, they're significantly more accurate in predicting sporting events. But again, that same exact amplification you could use for predicting financial markets, predicting sales, predicting medical decisions. So sports is just convenient because the data is there and it's available.
Yeah. Hey, what's the business case actually for using ASI in the betting industry, if any business case is there? But
yeah, so we definitely, we do take the predicting sporting events seriously, and we have interest from sports handicappers who want data from us about how to predict sporting events better. But the primary business case for our company is to do optimized forecasts and optimized decisions for large companies. And so we do take teams who are sales teams or marketing teams or business teams, and we connect them together and allow them to make more accurate predictions about their own business,
yeah.
which every business team would like to do.
Yeah. Hey, what makes the application of ASI to a group of average sport fans lead to higher group intelligence versus the group of vegas bettors, which could be argued is a swarm in itself, actually? Yeah,
yeah. So Vegas betting markets are a group of people. A swarm is a group of people. What we're seeing is the swarm outperforms the Vegas betting market. And the reason for that is that a market is a serial, sequential set of predictions. Each person who bets money in a market or places a bet in a stock market is influencing the person who comes after them. And that person influences the next person. And so what happens is, because each person is influencing the next person, you get these overshoots that in markets is called momentum, and you get these bubbles and busts in markets. Nature figured out in swarms how to solve this, which is instead of people interacting in series, they interact in parallel. So yeah, there's no leader, there's no follower, everybody's converging together on an answer, and so you don't get these bubbles and busts, you just get a more accurate forecast.
Clear. Yeah. Hey, what technological developments will bring ASI to the next level?
Yeah, so we're continuing to look at how we can make these systems smarter, and we think we're just at the start of this space. One of the things that we're really looking at is what happens when we get bigger and bigger groups of people. Yeah. Currently, when we pull together a swarm of sports fans, it's somewhere between 30 and 100 people in a swarm, but we're looking at what happens when that becomes 1,000 people or 5,000
yeah.
people. Can we have even greater amplification of intelligence?
Thank you so much, Louis.
Yeah.
Fascinating research, and we're going to follow you.
Great.
Thank you there at home, and if you're fascinated by this interview, go to the website of the Future Technologies Conference and you will find loads of other interviews. Thank you for your attention.